People seated later will miss out on the padded pews. So the first to get into the padded pews have the most comfortable seats.
Thank you. Vivian, we love you. We wish you happy birthday. Everybody, ladies and gentlemen, raise your glasses and let us toast. Miss Hewitt, on her 95th. Wish you all a safe and such good night. God bless you.
Vivian is one of our most cherished and special members of the Congregation of St. Xavier. It's been a delight to get to know in my few years here. I've been here only 14 years, and I haven't been alive as long as she has yet. Someone asks the question, have you lived here all your life? You know the answer is?
Yes.
Not yet.
Nice.
Right. Vivian's proof of that. We get to do a lot of special things in this magnificent cathedral. And I've gotten to see in my 14 years some pretty wonderful things and meet some extraordinary people. But tonight is one of those kinds of evenings. And Vivian is one of those people.
Hear, hear.
I got to thinking also as I've traveled, one of the things I've gotten very interested in, going back in time after some experiences in Egypt to Alexandria, thinking about Vivian the librarian. She could have the middle name, Marion. And what makes somebody like her a person so open to things, so wonderfully open to different kinds of people, to new ideas, even to change. She's seen a lot of change. And I think it has something to do with her understanding of what it means to be part of a library, a place that is a repository of knowledge that goes way back, but also helps us understand today and prepare for the future. So to our wonderful friend, Vivian, the librarian who has never stopped learning, whose spirit of discovery is an inspiration to all of us, you help us understand why life is so valuable because of the way you live it. Many blessings for another 95 years.
It is really my honor to stand in for my cousin, Dr. John Hamilton Hewitt III today. What I would like to say to a wonderful mother, a precious aunt, a wonderful grandmother, a wonderful great-grandmother, cousin, extended cousin, all of the friends and the many wonderful friends that we have. I just want to say to you, happy birthday, and that we love you. I would like to make this special toast to you. This is to the good life.
Thank you.
And to the life that's good.
Oh, thank you.
My name is Timothy Russell, and I've been asked by Vivian to represent all of you friends who had something wonderful to say as well. For a life full of love and affection and imagination and scholarship and service and volunteerism and charitable works known fully only to the Almighty. For the enrichment that we've had from you, as you've given to us of the richness of that fountain of life from which you have drunk so freely and so helpfully, Vivian, we all want to express our appreciation for nearly a century. And I think I speak for us all in saying, we hope we get invited back in 5 years. To the one who, in our hearts, is truly, sincerely, and deeply loved as the one and only, Vivian Davidson Hewitt, I give you our friend. And now, if the dean will join me here. Vivian has allowed me to have a prayer for you, which I will do as the dean and I stand next to her. And on behalf of her beloved congregation and all of her friends and Dr. John, who is with us in the spirit, we join together in praying for our dear friend. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, we thank you, O gracious God,
for such a loving, generous, faithful, caring, and giving servant,
from whom we have seen what is the essence of true religion, to care for those in need, to help and encourage, to love and befriend, and to walk humbly. We give you thanks for the gift of Vivian Davidson Hewitt to each of us to make humanity better, to bring glory to you, to enjoy and love the arts and every good thing. May she continue to be a font of blessing and care as we pray together and say, thank you, God, for Vivian. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, now I want to go up front. I want to go up. Thank you for the wonderful toast, and thank you all for being here. I hope you've had a good time. My niece Joyce, who was 10 years old when she was in my wedding in 1949, is like a daughter to me. She travels with me for the past 10 years or so when Dr. John isn't able to travel with me. I am so thrilled about this evening. Joyce has said to me, Aunt Vivian, you're always doing something for somebody else. Why don't you do something for yourself? This is my something to myself, to thank you for being my friend and for passing through my life and for enriching my life, for enlarging my life, for enhancing my life. There are people here from 10 states. My cousins are here from San Francisco, Los Angeles, Maryland, Washington, D.C., from everywhere. And even a couple from Copenhagen, Denmark, have come to be with me. And I'm so glad they're here. Each of you has touched my life in some way. The doctors who care for me, take care of my eyes, my knees, my hearing, you know, as you know, the aging process. But I wake up each morning and I say, thank you, dear Lord. I'm vertical, I'm mobile, but best of all, I have my wits about me. There are people here from every facet of my life, from my hometown, Newcastle, Pennsylvania, from my college, Geneva College, Beaver Falls, Pennsylvania, from my schools, Carnegie Institute of Technology, now Carnegie Mellon, and the University of Pittsburgh. And I'm so happy they are here. My Pittsburgh contingent is here, and I've never given up Pittsburgh. I love it. It helped make me and prepare me for New York. And I'm so glad that John Hewitt married me and brought me to New York and made it possible for me to have the positions that I had in the library world and to meet the people that I met. He was the only child of his mother's second marriage, and his brothers and sisters were teenagers when he came along. So I knew through them, because they knew everybody who was somebody in New York, I knew the tag end or some of the people of the Harlem Renaissance. And it's been a wonderful life. I've had a wonderful life and a marvelous life, a joyous life. And like Langston Hughes, my good friend, there have been tacks along the way, but I've been climbing and making my way, and I just love you. And the greatest thing in life is to love and be loved. And I love you all, and I'm loved by you. And I feel so blessed. And thank you for being here. Now, I hope you'll have some dessert, birthday cake, and some of her famous sweet potato tart, which, you know. And then I hope that you'll dance to some cheek-to-cheek music, not none of this doo-wop stuff, but music that we can enjoy. So thank you, and continue to enjoy the evening and drink champagne. Yeah, time to cut the cake.
To be like you. Happy, happy birthday, and may you have 95 more. This is Peg, and here's Willis.
Hi, Vivian. Such a pleasure to be here and help you celebrate your 95th. It's such a pleasure knowing you and, you know, being around you with your energy. I'm hoping that you have 95 plus more celebrations. And I want to be to each one of them. Happy birthday with love, Willis.
You know, this is Cecile Springer, all the way from Pittsburgh. I had to come for anybody like you off of your 95th birthday. And I bring greetings from North Carolina, especially the Museum of North Carolina, where we saw a show of yours. So our best wishes. Eric is not here, but he sends his best wishes too. So happy birthday, Vivian. Bye.
This is to wish Aunt Vivian many more wonderful years, And this is for our Northeast matriarch, Love from the Tribe. Bye.
Aunt Vivian, love you so, 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 so much. So happy to be here for your 95th after celebrating your 90th with you. And so happy to celebrate Mother's Day weekend with all of the wonderful moms here, including our mom.
Aunt Vivian, hello all the way from Los Angeles, California. We love you so, so much. Thank you for all the sleepovers at your apartment when we were in New York. And thank you for supporting my acting career. There's no better person to support the arts than you. Woo! Love you.
We love you, Aunt Vivian. Happy 95th.
Love you. Love you.
We love you.
We love you. We love you. We love you. We love you. We love you. We love you. We love you.
Happy birthday.
I just want to say a very, very happy birthday, Aunt Vivian. What you've contributed to just the earth and New York and our family has been absolutely amazing, and I'm really honored to be here tonight and wishing you many, many more. Mwah. Love you, Aunt Vivian.
Well, Mom, happy birthday. You have something in common with Sir Elton John now. You know, when you first said that you wanted to have your birthday at the cathedral, that's what I thought of. But I think you've outdone him. So happy birthday and many, many more. Love you.
Thank you so much. What a difference a day makes. 24 little hours. That's the sun and the flower.
Thank you.